How to communicate. I'd like to thank Deep Breath Technologies for sponsoring this video as part of my Kickstarter campaign. So how to communicate. We've talked a little bit about how the internet was designed, how things kind of communicate between different devices and break things up into different chunks and stuff like that. So we're going to continue on that discussion a little bit. So some parts that we need to communicate between two devices. Let's start out with two nodes here. So we're going to have device one and device two. And then that's going to be connected by a cable. And within these devices are network cards, which we'll talk about some more coming up. And they're going to do the communicating for us. So in order to communicate, we need to have a source and a destination. And we need to have an encoder and a decoder. So within this computer, let's say it's a computer, we need to take the data from the applications and put it in some sort of format through the network card to get it onto this cable. In order to do so, we need to encode it. So we need to have over here an encoder, which tells it how to put those bits onto the wire. And then over here, we're going to have to have a decoder. How do we interpret these bits that come and come to my network card and I receive them? We also have to have a transmitter and a receiver. So we need to have some sort of way of getting it onto the wire and then some sort of way of getting it off of the wire. We also have to have some sort of medium. So we drew this already, but this will be our medium. It could be copper, fiber, wireless, anything like that. Different flavors of each of those kinds, generic kinds of media. You have to have some sort of media to transmit across. So those are the basic parts we need to communicate. A source, a destination, an encoder, a decoder. Once it's encoded, it gets transmitted and then received. And that all goes across some sort of media. In order for the transmitter to send it onto the medium, we need to segment it into different pieces. So up here we'll have some sort of application that's running. That was terrible. Some sort of application that's running. And then that has to get down into our network card and get sent across the media. It needs to get that data from this application needs to get chopped up. So we got to cut it up into pieces that we call segmenting. And then those segments in turn get transmitted. So this gets transmitted, and then this gets transmitted, and then this gets transmitted. And then as they work their way across the wire, they then get received, and then they'll get built again. We'll go into more detail on this in coming videos. But that's the general idea, is it then gets built back piece by piece, and then we have our data over on this side. You can also, we'll change our color here, you can also have multiple applications or multiple communications across that same wire, that same media. This is called multiplexing. We can have, as I mentioned, the efficiency of packet switching networks are vastly more so than of circuit switching networks. This is why, because of multiplexing. So this could be, application number two is blue, and then it comes up on the other side. Or this could be some completely other computer on that same wire. We could have, someone down here, and he is source number two. He's got his little network card, and we'll make him purple. And then he also wants to talk on that same connection. So he's trying to talk to the destination as well. So we're going to multiplex his traffic right in there as well. And that's going to get to its destination. And then this guy over here, he's going to receive that same application. That's the general idea of multiplexing, is getting multiple communications on that same wire. Otherwise, you're not being efficient with its use. We have some devices here that we've already labeled, but we have what we'll talk about, like this junction here we're going to talk about. So we have devices on our network. This is considered an end device. This is an end device, or a host, or something, whatever you want to use for your terminology, but that's our end devices. They're going to generate and receive that data. So we have the transmitters and decoders and receivers and encoders. That's on this side here. We're creating some sort of data to be sent, receiving it over on the other side. In the middle, and we'll switch over, get rid of a little piece here. We're going to put a router just for fun. This is going to be our intermediary device. And this is really what we focus on in Cisco with CCNA. This is what we're going to worry about. We may have other devices in here as well, but this is what we consider an intermediary device. Oops, there we go. And you know what, we'll put another one in here too, so we cover both aspects of common intermediary devices. We'll put a switch in here as well. So here's a switch, and then he might have someone else coming off of that as well. So we'll talk about switches and routers and how they make this destination too. We'll talk about routers and switches and how they differ and how they're similar coming up. But this is also considered an intermediary device. So I mentioned we have the media. That could be copper, fiber, radio waves. Each one has its own method of transmitting and encoding on how to get across that media. Even within fiber or copper or radio waves, there's many different versions and different protocols to use within that. Things have changed over the years. You know, we've gone from 10 megabit per second networks up to 10 gigabit per second networks, and each step of the way has had a different encoding method to use, a different way of accessing that media to get that level of quality and speed. Across these networks, what we're encoding and transmitting and receiving and such, these are what we consider services. So maybe this is, let's say this is a server over here, and he's hosting websites. So he's hosting HTTP. That's a service. So that's what we're going to consider a service. Kind of makes sense, right? Server, service. Although it could be on a host as well. When we run TFTP on our computers to transmit a bin file of the iOS to our routers and switches, we are hosting a TFTP service on our PC and in turn turning it into a server, essentially. So that's going to be a service, and then HTTP, that's what these green guys could be, for example. So these little segments could be little HTTP packets transmitting across. You can have a bunch of different ones. This could be FTP. The other one could be, let's say, maybe this is VoIP. So we'll say this is a phone. And so this could be VoIP. That's how we get everything onto one network, and how we communicate is by using these network cards to and the OSI layers, which we'll get into, to take an application's data, break it up into segments, encode it, and transmit it across the wire. it'll most likely go through some sort of intermediary device or multiples of on its way to its destination. It'll then be received and decoded and then rebuilt into some sort of an application or data for some use by the other side. Any of these protocols we're talking, a lot of these applications and protocols we're talking about, we consider them services, especially when you're talking about the client-server model that we'll be getting into is the services that we refer to that are commonly used. That's what these are, HTTP, FTP, VoIP, all sorts of different ones out there, SMTP, POP, you know, whatever you want to call them. They're all services of some kind. So going from this, we're going to be expanding into the sizes of networks. So now that we know how the basic idea of network communication works, well, how big can I get a network? What kind of design can I make? This is kind of a messy network here. We've got some little router in here. We got some random switch with a bunch of devices spewing off. It doesn't really make much sense. We'll get into, you know, how large can I make it? What's the proper way of designing it? What are the terms used for the different sizes of networks? LANs, WANs, PANs, MANs, etc. All those ANs. We'll get into that. As well as some of the more detailed information about what the physical side is of interconnecting the within large networks. I'd like to thank Deep Breath Technologies for sponsoring this video as part of my Kickstarter campaign.